One of our key projects is hanging in the balance. It is compromised.
Yung bantay ng bayan part, nakakalimutan ng tao.
As a tool, analyzing the data sets, especially the logs.
We don't know. The reason for the delay in the accreditation, actually partial accreditation, like I said, no? Na we've been accredited for the RMA. The second major activity, the AES monitoring and observation, does not really need accreditation. We can do that, no? But of course, yung, the third one involves access to data. Yes, it's a flagship project to provide information to the public. Okay. Yun yung wala pang accreditation, but we're still pushing. It starts with open data. In fact, yung government natin, meron siyang open data website where information from government agencies are posted and people have access to it. Now, that concept of open data is extended to elections. So we call it open elections data. Ano ba yung iniisip namin in particular for the open elections data? Because our elections have been automated since 2010, no? The system actually generates a lot of data, no? That may give us indications on the network performance, system performance. Not only that, those are technical issues, but would we be able to track, say, irregularities that might have happened, no? During the elections?
So the main feature of the open data is the some of the almost real-time updates of the
projects. Yes, close to real-time as much as possible. But we know, like for example, no, election results, they can come in as close a real-time as possible.
Are you still confident that Comelec will approve you?
We're still pushing. I'm makulit about the data so that we can provide assistance to the Comelec to really make an informed assessment of how the automated election system performed.